Hey guys, in this video, we'll talk about how to create a translation app using bubble.io and GPT 3.5 Turbo by OpenAI, which is also known as ChatGPT API. This is my bubble editor. If you have an account, you can log in with your account, or if you don't have an account, you can just sign up with your email ID. So then click on create an app. Here you are going to put the name of your app. So let me put GPT trans, that stands for translation, and it says the name is available. So let's create the app. So we are going to build a complete translation software. So we are going to skip everything. We'll start from scratch. All right, let's preview it. Right now, this is completely blank. So what we need actually, we need two text boxes. One will be our input, where users will put their input text, and another text box will be output, where GPT 3.5 Turbo will show you the output. All right. At the same time, we also need a drop down with the names of the languages. And we also need a button to trigger the translation. All right. So when the user will put their input text and they will select the language they want to translate, and after that, if they hit the button, GPT 3.5 Turbo will translate their text to that language. So let's go and create. So first we need an input text box. So that will be multi-line input. You can have that from here, input forms and multi-line input. So I'm going to put my input here. This is going to be the input I'm talking about. This is just a text box, but this is our input text box. All right. So let's give it a border so you can see that. All right. Let's go to design again. Okay. We can see that. So this is our input. All right. So we need to create an output box here. First, let me add some padding to it. Let me add like 15, 15, 15, and 15. So, okay, it's good. Let me add a text box for our output. So I should make it the same size, 408,392. All right. 408, and this is 392. All right. This is done. All right. So let me add a bit of padding here also. Go to layout and should be 15, 15, 15, 15. All right. And let me edit a bit. Let me give it a background so that you can see that as the output box. So let me make the font size to 18. And from here also, we are going to make our font size to 18. All right. We have our input text box here, and we also have an output text box here. Now we need a drop down for our languages. So let's click on drop down from input forms and just bring that drop down here. I'll write somewhere here. And for choices, for now, I'm adding Spanish and French. And Hindi, English. Right? So we are going to have four language options. You can add as many as languages you want. All right, that's it. This is our dropdown. Let's preview. This is our input box. This is our output box. And this is our language dropdown. We need a button here to translate. Let's give it a button. So click on button and just drag and drop. Translate. Let me drag this to here. User will input their text here. Then they will choose a language. And then they will hit translate. GPT 3.5 Turbo will translate it for us. So we are done with our interface. Now let's go to our backend. So click on plugins, then click on add plugins, and then install the API connector. And click on add another API, and we are going to use OpenAI. All right. Authentication, I will set it to self-handled. Let's expand it. Here I'll put GPT 3.5, GPT 3.5. And this is going to be a post request. And let's 1.5 API. Let's search for it for the documentation. Here we have the documentation. So the authorization will be bearer plus our OpenAI's key. So let's grab this and shared header value. Here we are going to replace our OpenAI key. This is my OpenAI key. All right. Remember to have a space between these two. And here we'll have an action because we are going to trigger it. And for the post, we are going to paste the curl here. And we need another header. Here we are going to put content type. And application slash JSON. All right. So body type JSON. Then we are going to put our body from here to here. Model is GPT 3.5 Turbo. And this is our prompt. All right. One is input text, another is language. What will be our command to GPT 3.5 Turbo? Translate our input text to this language. So translate our input text to Spanish. Translate our input text to French. Translate our input text to Hindi. Before we use ChatGPT API or GPT 3.5 Turbo, we have to initialize the call. So let's put some value here. And language, let me say it in French. Let's initialize the call and let's see it translates it or not. Let's see the show data. We got the text. Let's go to Google Translate and check it. All right. We got the perfect translation from GPT 3.5 Turbo. So let's save it and let's go to our design. Let's name it to input text. Let's name it to output, right? Button translate. This is our dropdown. All right. Let's click on translate and start edit the workflow. So click here and OpenAI GPT 3.5 Turbo. Input text. We need a dynamic text. So we are going to put our value of input text box. Language. We need a dynamic value. So we'll put the value of our dropdown. All right. So another action, whatever the output is, we are going to store it in a state of index page. Then we'll fetch it from there. So set a state of an element. The element would be our index page. This is our index page and create a custom state translate. And the state type will be text. Let's create the state. And let's go to our design. And in the placeholder, we'll leave it black. And here in the placeholder, I'll insert the translate. That's it. And I think we are done. Let's preview it. Today is Monday. Right. Let's choose an option for translation. I'll choose French again and let's translate it. We got nothing because we did a simple mistake. So let's go to workflow and here let's put the value. Results of the step one. And then the choices and the first item and first item's message content. Let's do it again. This is Monday and let's French. Oh, all right. Does that mean I don't know French? It's Monday. All right. This is Monday. It's Monday. Let's translate it to Hindi. It's Monday. All right. Let's translate it to Spanish. All right. Let's check it. This is Monday. All right. We are done. If you liked this video, please share and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.